So guys, I just had lunch with my cousin Luis. He's working close by. Jonas, the friend of ours that we met in Kolding when we were studying in Kolding. Go back to the videos of Denmark if you want to check who is it. Now I'm going to check some startups and some conferences again. At the end of the day will be the closing ceremony. I'll try to be there in first line to show to you. The Republic President of Portugal always trying, talking about the challenges for Portugal and for Web Summit next year. So that's it. Will be. It's always a great ceremony. And yeah, now let's go for the content creator stage. Where is it? I think it's there.
This is great. Look at this crowd.
It's less about you and more about understanding your audience and creating something that they will engage with and they'll find it fun to share, or they will share because they want to have bragging rights on the topic or something like this.
We were talking about this earlier, weren't we? The worst kind of branded content is a bit like when someone gate crashes a party and just insists on telling you all about themselves and then exits. Yeah.
Exactly. So in other words, what you were saying backstage, which is, if you're going to create content, create good content, regardless of who's making it.
But understanding what the brand is about is really key, because I think that the worst brief that you can give to an agency or to a creative partner is like, hey, go create a viral video. Go create content. You know what I mean? Like, it's like, it's what? Like, where do I even start? You know, like, or someone comes and says like, oh, I want you to do a campaign like that, and referring to another brand. You can't. That has been done already. So you need to really understand what your brand can offer. You know, like what role your brand will play on the story, and focus on the story itself.
Ceremony. Really cool, the conversation that was now on PandaConf about influencers. And exactly understanding if the influencer marketing, if there's value, what's the meaning of influencer, and the difference between influencer and content creator. As Casper Lee was saying, he's a content creator, not an influencer. Influencer can be like singers, athletes, whatever. Even though content creators also influence people. Understanding exactly how is it to monetize their work, their content. How do companies choose and why do they choose to collaborate with content creators and influencers? And how do consumers perceive the value? Now going there for the closing ceremony. Hope you're enjoying Web Summit. I'm enjoying a lot. Let's go.
Who is the winner?
You three. You three.
Now armed with those vast new powers, she's here to tell us about the task that still lies ahead. In conversation with Laurie Siegel, please give a huge, welcome to Marguerite Messiah.
in Europe over the last 10 years has developed a vibrant, dynamic startup community with a lot of also scale-up potential. You see small startups, you see the giant businesses, you see how there is an appetite to use digital technologies for all kind of different things. If tech sort of gets something that is only embedded in giant companies, that is beyond our democracy.
And finally, I'd like to welcome to the stage the President of Portugal.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Gary, first of all. From all over the world, 170 countries. It's amazing. 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019. And we did it. Lisbon, Portugal became city and country, a key center of the digital revolution, of the tech revolution. But at the same time, we have started had, in a sense, anticipated most of the key changes of this tech revolution. With Stephen Hawkins, we discussed science, technology, life, death, past, present, future. With Allgore, we anticipated climate change and global warming. We anticipated reality. With Guterres, we spoke of multilateralism at the time when too many just spoke of unilateralism, of protectionism, of no dialogue, of war, trade war, currency war. With Michel Barnier, this year, we spoke of Europe and the role of Europe in the global world. With Margaret Vestager, we just addressed the problem of competition, of the digital, of the technological change. We address here, far ahead, all the many, many and key changes and challenges of the present and the future. We're doing it with privacy. We spoke of privacy this year. We spoke with no fear of manipulation coming from both political powers and economic powers. We need a strong democracy and a civic culture where nobody is left behind. That's another key point. Well, thank you very much. On behalf of all the Portuguese, of the younger generation, that are living as heroes this tech revolution, this digital revolution, with new investments, with new startups, with a new mentality. But the whole country, the whole society, and those that come from abroad, all of us, we must still want to anticipate the key issues of the future. We do not fear the future. We are unstoppable. Nobody will stop us. Nobody. 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 Thank you, Gary. Thank you all. See you next year. Goodbye.
So guys, I hope you enjoyed the content. It was really good to be here. Margaret just talked about her role in the European Commission, about legislation for technology in Europe. That big companies, small companies, everything needs to be balanced. Not only the big companies should not take advantage because they are bigger. They should have to pay fines if they have to. Not more, not less. They have to pay what is supposed to be paid. For a more competitive world, we are looking for an Europe where the legislation is good for everyone and allows everyone to be in a fair trade and a fair competitive world in the technology. Hope you enjoyed the Lab Summit. It was really good. I'll try to be here next year again. See you guys on my next vlog.